See, what we have is pictures that I picked up just by accident. There was a woman who came to interview me about the rock. And at the interview, she said, you know, there's somebody here at the restaurant that has this movie of a whole bunch of different things that are taking place in Ann Arbor, like a rock being moved and trees being lifted and people flying airplanes around Ann Arbor and a whole lot of different things. And she hadn't any idea where they came from or what they are. And I said, you know, I'd really like to have that. And what these are things that happened with the Ann Arbor Park system kind of in the very early 1930s, probably 1931, 1932. We're going to start out at the Ann Arbor Airport, which was dedicated in 1926, which was only about 20 years after people discovered they could fly an airplane. This is, I think, the photographer, because he's in quite a few of the things, and I don't know really who it is. But he's standing next to, this is Leonard Flo's Waco, and this is the airport hangar that's now gone. And this is Leonard going up to show us how fancy he can be in his Waco. He was the first person to land the plane at the Ann Arbor Airport. And he was quite a dashing figure around town because people didn't fly airplanes that much. So he's gonna show what his plane will do. It's kind of interesting to see how the tail goes down, bringing the nose up. Now this is about 1931 Stinson. They were made nearby in Wayne, and people kind of wonder why he's turning the prop backwards, that he does know what he's doing. What he's doing is putting oil in the cylinders before he starts the engine. Now we're going to try and start it. This is kind of a dangerous enterprise. They didn't have self-starters, and it was really quick to trim your fingernails if you didn't do it just right. And this is a plane that a lot of people went flying, had their first flight around Ann Arbor. Everyone knew the plane and the owner. And there's the dashing man himself. That's Leonard Flo. Now the Ann Arbor Airport, to support it, Eli Gallup kind of leased the area around it for farmers to grow oats. And that helped. The airport itself is built on the field that we use for water for Ann Arbor. There's four wells out there, there's three that are still in use. And here we take off and we'll take a little tour around the airport. Gravel runways at that time. There's the big hangar, which is now torn down. But we circle the airport and we'll head off towards town. There's just two runways. Now it's all built up around here now. In 1932, there was practically no houses. The airport was way out in the country. Now we're coming up by Ann Arbor High School and the Michigan Stadium. We're flying over Ann Arbor High School right now. Notice that there's still a lot of open land even there. The Michigan Stadium before a couple of renovations. No Chrysler Arena. That's Ferry Field with the baseball diamond, and the IM building, and Yost Fieldhouse at the bottom. Packard State. Now we're a couple over the University of Michigan. The V-shaped building is a museum of natural history. Now we're going over kind of the east side of Ann Arbor, out Washtenaw. Now we're going right down State Street. That's Angel Hall with the observatory, Michigan Union. West Park, no, we made a quick trip. Now the west side of town, we're going out towards what was in those days the fairgrounds, but is now Veterans Park. That's the racetrack at the fairgrounds. Again, you notice no houses any place around, it's all built up now. Now we're going down the Huron River, Barton Pond. Railroad running alongside of the pond. There's a dam at Barton. Moving downstream towards the University Hospitals area. That's where the hospital is now, but nowhere near the structure that we're used to at this time. That's Fuller Field, kind of the oxbow of the river there, Fuller Road right at the bottom of the screen. And then we're going to be going down towards Gallup Park. That would be Gallup Park now. The Edison Company sold all the river rights from the Barton Dam that we just flew over all the way down to Gallup Park and beyond, and Eli was able to procure that for the city at a very reasonable price because they wanted to get rid of it and they were very cooperative with the city, and they could have sold it off to individual landowners who would love to have a house on the river or a restaurant, but the way it went is the city got those river rights. And it makes the whole town a different place now because of having that, including Gallup Park, which was named after him.